that hand and wave it at me. I said, wave your hand at me. Praise the Lord. Why don't you stand up? We are ready for something glorious and something wonderful, something beautiful in your life this year in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your compassion. We thank you for your promise. We thank you for your covenant. We thank you, Lord, for what you have in mind for every child of God, every member of this church, the young and the old, and even our invitees this year. Lord, we pray none of us will miss our blessing in Jesus' name. We're asking, oh Lord, that you pave the way before us. And you lead us to that wonderful, beautiful, glorious future in Jesus' name. We cancel all those negative things of the past in Jesus' name. We bury the past and we're asking, Lord, something new. We're resurrecting every life in Jesus' name. Hold our hand. Take us to that glorious future. We pray that at the end of this year, Lord, we'll be able to testify everyone that this year has been very different from every other year in our lives. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Give me another amen. Amen. Thank you very much. You can sit down. We're looking at Mark chapter 4. Mark chapter 4. I'm reading from verse 35. Mark chapter 4. Verse 35, and the same day, when the evening was come, he says unto them, let us pass over unto the other side. The Lord Jesus has been teaching his disciples in chapter 4. It's been like a passive chapter. Everybody just sitting down and listening. But thank God, number one, they were attentive. And it's so wonderful when we hear the word of God and we sit down and we're attentive. Number two, they were retentive. That means that they retained what they heard. It wasn't just something passing and going before them. Attentive, retentive, receptive. They were receptive. And because they were receptive, the Lord had been watching them. That's why he's not leading them and he's saying, if you have been attentive and retentive and receptive, now you need to be productive. That's why he said, let us pass on, passing over onto the other side. You're going to be productive this year in Jesus' name. I want to talk to you from this passage on our faith journey to the promised future. A faith journey to the promised future. When Jesus Christ said to those disciples, let us pass over onto the other side. As you keep on reading and reading and reading, and you come to the first verse of chapter 5. In chapter 5 verse 1, and they came over onto the other side. I just want to tell you, there is nothing the devil can do this year to stop your progress in Jesus' name. When he says, when he gives us the word, he says, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall never pass away. And it doesn't matter when he gives that word, January or February, March or April, May or June or July, August or September, October, September, or it's October, November or December. Anytime he gives the word, that word will be fulfilled in your life in Jesus' name. Let us pass over onto the other side. And then the word of God records, and they came over onto the other side. You are getting over to the other side in Jesus' name. Our faith journey to the promised future. There are three things we're going to look at. Number one, the purpose of his calling to an expected future. You have expectation, and the expectation of the righteous shall not be disappointed in Jesus' name. And we're talking about the purpose of his calling to an expected future. Number two, our progress with Christ towards the expedient future, the profitable future, the positive future, and the exciting future that the Lord is spreading before us. Our progress with Christ towards our expedient future. Number three, is the privilege of Christians with an expanding future. An expanding future. You'll see it as they came to the other side, the future just kept on expanding and expanding. there's an extension for your life this year, an expansion for your life this year, an establishment for life this year in Jesus' name. Number one, the purpose of his calling to an expected future. Why did he say, let us pass over onto the other side? What did he have in mind? He saw the future. He knows the end from the beginning. He knows what this year will be. He knows what you are going to have. That's what the Lord is telling you ahead of time. There's an expected future, and it is going to be realized this year. It will be done. Nothing will hinder it in Jesus' name. I'm looking at this once again in Mark chapter 4 verse 35. Mark chapter 4 verse 35. And the same day, when the even was come, he says unto them, let us pass over unto the other side. The question is, why will he pass over to the other side? None of those disciples knew what was going to happen, but Jesus knew what is going to happen. Let me read to you Jeremiah chapter 29, reading there from verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you. The disciples didn't know, but Jesus knew why he said, let us pass over onto the other side. And you may not know why the Lord has brought you here today, but the Lord knows why you are here. He'll perfect everything concerning you. He says, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. It is coming. I said it is coming to give you an expected end. But he tells us what we're going to do. Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. All your prayers this year, he will answer. Don't you ever think back. I prayed last year and this did not happen. That did not happen. This year is very different. The expectation you have and the desire that you have and the fulfillment you're expecting, it is this year, it will be done in Jesus' name. It says, well, I know the thoughts. My thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are my ways your ways. Everything he has declared, everything he has decreed, everything will be fulfilled. He says, then you will go and pray unto me. And then he says, he will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all your heart. This year, you are going to find the Lord. You are going to find his favor, and you are going to find everything he has promised in fulfillment in Jesus' name. There are seven words the Lord is giving us for this year. As he tells us, let us pass over to the other side. And I want you to keep all these words in your mind. And then every time you pass from Monday to Tuesday, every time you pass from one week to the other, every time you pass from one month to the other, you understand the reason why you are passing on from one day to the other, from one week to the other, from one month to the other, and from this year to the following year. There is a purpose, there is a goal, there is something he has in mind. And they are all kind of summarized in these words. I'm going to tell you, number one is the word better. Number one is the word what? Better. Number two, higher. Number three, stronger. Because he wants to get us to the other side. The other side of weakness. The other side of impotence. The other side of inactivity. That, you know, we've been folding our hands. The other side of sorrow, the other side of sickness, this year will be different in Jesus' name. Number four, purer. Number five, healthier. This year is a year of strength, a year of health. You'll be strong and healthy in Jesus' name. Number six, greater. Number seven, more and more. I said more and more. Whatever you have got, more and more. Whatever you have seen, more and more. Whatever you have experienced, more and more. Number one, the purpose of his calling to an expected future. Number one is the word better. Look at Ezekiel chapter 36. Ezekiel chapter 36. The reason he's calling you and calling me, calling us together, and he said, let's pass on. We'll be too long in this place we've been. We've been going around the same pole, the same pillar, the same situation, the same environment. And he says, we're moving on. We need something better. I want to give you and show you something better. Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 11. And I will multiply upon you man and beast, and they shall increase and bring forth fruit. And I will settle you after your old estates, and will do better unto you than at your beginnings. And ye shall know that I am the Lord. The Lord says, I'm going to convince this unit here, I am your God. You will know that I am the Lord your God when I give you better things. So the purpose of his moving us on to the other side, number one, better. Number two, higher. I'm looking at Psalm 89. Psalm 89. In Psalm 89, we're reading from verse 27. Psalm 89, we're thinking of verse 27. It says, it wants to make you higher than all the people you know. 89, verse 27. It says, also I will make him, my firstborn, higher than the kings of the earth. Higher than the kings of the earth. You see, all this in the future. All this, I will do this. I'll do this. And he gives you the word, and he says, this is what I'm going to be thinking about this year, because there is an expectation of the righteous, and that expectation starts with the word better, and then the word higher. We're looking at Psalm 61. In Psalm 61, look at verse 2 there, from the ends of the earth, when I cry unto thee, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. The next word is stronger. If you are weak today, you'll be stronger at the end of this meeting. If you're weak in the past, this year will be the year of your strength in Jesus' name. All the things that came to weaken your life and weaken your family and weaken everything around you and weaken your hand, all those things will be blown away by the power of the Holy Ghost even today in Jesus' name. You will be strong. If you were strong before, you will be stronger. It tells us in Job chapter 17, Job chapter 17, and there we're reading from verse 9. Job chapter 17. We're looking at verse 9, 17, verse 9. The righteous also. I want to know whether the people I'm talking about are there, the righteous also. We shall be righteous. I said be righteous. By the cleansing of the blood of the Lamb, we shall be righteous. By the help of the Holy Ghost, living and abiding within us, it'll make us to live a righteous, victorious, pure life in Jesus' name. And as it brings us to this side of righteousness, look at what it does in verse 9. The righteous also shall hold on his way, and he that has clean hands shall be stronger and stronger. Everybody say stronger and stronger. Now you must believe the promise of God. It says, I'm taking you to the other side. And then, but you know, the people that always say, I am weak. You know, I'm changing my language. How many of you are changing your language? You're changing your thinking. It's your thinking that brings what you say. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Two cannot talk together except be agreed. Agree with God. God says this year is better. God says this year is greater. God says this year you are stronger. And when you agree with God, you'll be stronger and stronger in Jesus' name. Psalm 105, we're looking at verse 24. Psalm 105, verse 24. And he increased his people greatly, and he made them stronger than their enemies. He made them stronger than their enemies. That's for this year. We've been waiting for this for a long time. For a long time, our enemies have been stronger than we were. But now this year, something is going to turn around. The strength will leave the camp of the enemy, and the people of God, the righteous, will not be stronger than their enemies in Jesus' name. Number four, purer. That is whiter and purer. Whiter and purer. We're looking at Psalm 51 verse 7. Psalm 51 verse 7. Here is the prayer of the man of God, of the king of Israel. And here is what your prayer ought to be. And since God says he'll answer your prayer, this is the year of purification. It's the year of sanctification. It's the year of purity. It will happen in our lives. I'm looking at Psalm 51 verse 7. Purge me with hyssop and I shall be clean. This year you are clean. I said you are clean. All the pollution that the enemy tries to put upon you, which is not yours, it will be cleansed away in Jesus' name. It says, wash me and put me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. It's a year of holiness. It's a year of purity. It's a year of righteousness. And you're purer than you have ever been in Jesus' name. Now you're going to be healthier this year. I said you'll be healthier this year. Any kind of sickness or weakness or infirmity or oppression abiding your life, today we're going to shake everything away. And you go out of that gate today, you go out of this place today, a healthier person. Because every sickness the Lord will remove away from the midst of us. Your wife will be healthy. Your husband will be healthy. Your children will be healthy. Your pastor will be healthy. Look up at me here. Look up at me. Your father in the Lord will be healthy. And like father, like children, all of us, we're going to be strong and healthy in Jesus' name. Because you know, this is the strongest year of our lives. The healthiest year of our lives. And the most prosperous year of our lives in Jesus' name. This year is different. I said this year is different. I mean, by the time you're having Covenant Sunday in February, you already know it's a different thing. And you brought difference here today. And you're going to be partakers of that difference in Jesus' name. Healthier, healthier people. Look at Job chapter 33. Job chapter 33. And we're reading from verse 23. Job chapter 33. And here we're reading from verse 23. In verse 23, here is what it says. It says, if there be a messenger with him, an interpreter, one among a thousand, to show unto man his uprightness. And it goes on, then he is gracious unto him, and saith, deliver him from going down to the pit. No premature death here this year. I have found a ransom. His flesh shall be fresher than the child. He shall return to the days of his youth. He shall return to the days of his youth. The Lord is saying, look at your past and look at, pick up a particular year. When you say, I remember that particular year when I was young. No headache, no stomach problem, no weakness, nothing at all. I was as strong as, what do they say now? And healthy. And then the Lord is saying, you are returning back to that day of youth. When you were strong and healthy, no problem, no heartache, no sorrow at all, and no sickness at all, and you were just strong, and you could run 1,000 miles at that time. That's what you thought. And the Lord is saying, those days have come back again in Jesus' name. Because his flesh shall be fresher than the child's, he shall return to the days of his youth. Look at verse 26. He shall pray unto God, and he will be favorable unto him. The Lord will show you favor. And he shall see his face with joy, for he will render unto man his righteousness. Number 6 is the word greater. Greater. Look at John chapter 14. John chapter 14. I'm reading there from verse 12. John chapter 14, verse 12. It says, verily, verily, I say unto you. Who is the Lord talking to here? Peter. He's talking to James. He's talking to John. Talking to the pastor. Who is he talking to here? Wonderful year. Wonderful year. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth in me, the works I do, he shall do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. Because it's for the Father. And that is what he's demanding from the Father concerning you. That greater thing is going to happen this year. Haggai chapter 2. Haggai chapter 2. I'm reading there from verse 9. Haggai chapter 2 verse 9. The glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former. As I look at you, the temple of God, as I look at you, the house of God, and as I look at this old church, the glory of this latter house shall be greater than that of the former in Jesus' name. Then says the Lord of hosts, in this place will I give peace, says the Lord of hosts. And I want you to remember, whatever challenge you are facing this year, the greater one lives inside you. And because the greater one abides in you, nothing will defeat you in Jesus' name. First John chapter 4, and I'm reading from verse 4. Ye of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Who is in the world? Satan in the world. The one who lives inside you is greater than Satan. All those powers of darkness in the world, the one who lives inside you is greater than all those powers of darkness. All those destroyers in the night and destroyers in the day. The one that lives inside you, greater is he that abides and dwells in you than he that lives in the world. And now he gives us the final thing after is better, after higher, after being stronger, after being whiter and purer, after being healthier and greater, he now says more and more. You wake up any day this year, you say, praise the Lord, today is the day of more and more. And then this week, we're beginning this week now, this is the week of more and more. And this month is the month of more and more. And this year is the year of more and more. Look at Psalm 115. I'm reading there from verse 14. Always remember that this year, don't just bow your head in sorrow and say, it's come again, the problems have begun again, the harassment of the devil has started, the sorrow has started again. Don't say that, because this is a different year. Come on and come over to the other side. And let those better things be revealed unto you. And let those higher things be given unto you. And let the stronger life and the stronger one live big in you. Let the greater one live in you and make you pure and make you healthier. Don't say, this year they have started again. Nothing of the past will start this year again in Jesus' name. More and more, more and more, more and more. Look at Psalm 115 verse 14. The Lord shall increase you more and more. Your business, more and more. Your schooling, more and more. Your family, more and more. And then, you know, those who are not married, they say, well, I'm not married yet. I'm going to have more and more. Just wait. Be listening for the announcement. I'm going to get all those single people together. All these people that, you know, above 25, 27, 33, 40 something. And then they are not married yet. I'm going to break whatever yoke is there in your life this year. And then when you hear the announcement, you say, all those single people, men and women, come together. If I'm having it here, then all the people everywhere, you are gathered together. And with one single stroke, we're going to break every yoke in Jesus' name. Not only that, this year is the year of more and more. After I finish with the singles, I'm going to get on the couples. All the couples, they say, look at our lives, Pastor, and seeking for counseling. Everything you are looking for in counseling, I'm going to get everybody together in one single stroke. And then I break every, the anointing that breaks the yoke is going to be operating this year in Jesus' name. And then I bring all those families together, and then we say more and more. And then when I, maybe before I finish that, I'm going to get on our young people, the younger people. When are we going to hear his voice? You know, I spoke to the national coordinator of youth this week, and I was telling him, and tell me the time the exam of these young people, tell me the time when the exam is coming. And before that exam comes, I'm going to get all the young people together, and I'm going to take the whip and drive that failure away from their lives. But you know, this year, when I turn to the youth, it is more and more. I turn to the singles more and more. I turn to the adults more and more. And then the workers, you know, the workers, we just finished our mini congress about 2 weeks ago, and some just finished it last week. And then I want them to rest and swallow and sink in what they have heard during that mini congress. And then a few weeks from now, I'm going to get all those workers together. I'm going to brush them up. I'm going to cleanse them and wash them. All those sins, the cobweb of the devil inside anybody's brain, I get all those workers together, sweep everything away, so that what I'm talking about, pastor, is more and more. I'm talking to the workers, is more and more. I'm talking to the families, is more and more. And I'm talking to those youths, more and more. I was checking all my notes. I said, why about all our congress, campus congress and all that? I get all those campus people together. I'm telling you, this year, more and more. Everybody shout, more and more. It will happen. I said it will happen. You will see the blessing of God overflowing in your life in Jesus' name. And look at Psalm 115, verse 14. The Lord shall increase you more and more. You and your children. You and your children. You and your children. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 18. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 18. But the path of the just is as the shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. Give me a good amen. Point number two now. Point number two. Our progress with Christ towards an expedient future. Our progress with Christ towards an expedient future. I'm coming back to Mark chapter 4. Mark chapter 4, I'm reading now from verse 36. After Jesus Christ said, let us pass over onto the other side. Then they moved on and see what happened. I'm reading this to you so that you will understand. No matter what happens between now and December, we're going to get to that other side. And don't say what, but look at this, but look at this, but look at this. We're going to be looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And we know that whatever may happen in this journey of faith, we're going to get to that better side, higher side, greater side in Jesus' name. Look at verse 36. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship. And there were also with him other little ships. And there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. And he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on a pillow. And they awake him and say unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he arose and rebuked the wind, and said unto the sea, peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. Praise the Lord. And he said unto them, why are ye so fearful? How is it that ye have no faith? And they feared exceedingly, and said one to another, what manner of man is this, that even the winds and the waves obey him? Even the winds and the waves obey him. It will happen again. I want to look at some things in this, the passage I read to you. We're talking about our progress with Christ. As Christ was in the ship, he went to sleep. And then a great storm arose. Then they shouted in fear, don't you care that we'll perish? And they woke him up. And he said, why are you so much afraid? How is it of little faith or no faith? And then he rebuked the wind, and I was a great calm. Let me just show you some things on our journey. Number one, a powerful partnership. A powerful partnership. On this faith journey, if we're going to get to this other side, the number one thing we ought to understand is that there is going to be a powerful partnership. Look at verse 36. Verse 36, it says, and when they had sent them the multitude away, they took him even as he was in the ship, because he had said, let us pass over. Let us pass over. Don't take a step this year without Christ. Without me, you can do nothing. Let a powerful partnership be established in your life, in your place of work. Acknowledge Him. Any project you are going to start, acknowledge Him. Anything you are going to do at the very beginning, acknowledge Him. Because it is that powerful partnership that will make you to be able to have all the fulfillment of the promises of God. And you know that He has said, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. That's powerful partnership. A partnership with Christ, that's number one. A partnership with God, that's number two. A partnership with the Holy Spirit, that's number three. A partnership even with the angels of God, that's number four. A partnership with another believer. If two of you shall agree together, as touching anything, find a believer. Find somebody who knows God, somebody who believes God, and somebody who accepts the promises of God and be in partnership with them in prayer. If two of you shall agree, as touching anything that you ask, I will do unto you. Number one, powerful partnership. Let us go over onto the other side. He didn't just say, you go over to the other side. He said, I'm going with you. And thank God He was in the boat, and thank God Jesus is in your life. I said, He is in your life. Number two, now, predictable problem. Predictable, I think Peter should have known this. John should have known. James should have known. They were fishermen. When you get on the sea, there is storm. And they should have known that. Number two then was a predictable problem. Look at verse 37. And there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. The Lord has told us that, you know, there are problems in the world, persecution in the world, pressure in the world. That's predictable. That should not make us afraid and say, well, if the problems are there, that means we cannot get to the other side anymore. In spite of those problems, I will get to where I will get to. In spite of persecution, the church will get to where it will get to in Jesus' name. In spite of all the harassments of the devil, the problems are predictable. A predictable problem, when those fishermen got on the sea, they should know there's going to be a storm. But the storm will not stop our Lord in Jesus' name. And look at John chapter 16. John chapter 16, verse 33. It says, this is have I spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, testing, trial, trouble, predictable problem. But then it says, be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. The Lord has overcome on your behalf, and you will overcome in Jesus' name. Number three, peaceful posture. Peaceful posture. You see, your posture matters a lot. Whenever there's a problem, whenever there's a storm, your attitude, your reaction, the way you manifest your emotion, it shows quite a lot. You ought to have a kind of peaceful posture. Do you remember that woman? That the woman got a miracle child, and then the child became sick. And the father said, take this child to the mother. And while the child was, the child died. And then the mother laid that dead child there, and eventually got to her husband, saying, husband, I'm going to see the prophet. What's the matter? Today is not a new moon. Today is not a worship day. It's not a day for revival. What are you going to see? He said, it shall be well. And then, give me a horse. And then what I told the horse man, he said, just keep on riding. I need to get to the man of God in time. And as the man of God saw her coming, he said, Gehazi, go and ask, is it well with you? Tell me. Have that peaceful posture that this year, whatever is happening, whatever the storm, a peaceful posture. Is it well with your husband? Say it aloud. And then, is it well with the child? That's how you are going to say it. It is well. And the child was dead already. And she knew the fact that the child was dead. But she also knew the truth, that there's resurrection power through prayer. The fact is that the child was dead. The truth is that there is resurrection power. And the truth that you know will cancel and crush all the facts of life in your life in Jesus' name. And eventually the man of God went there. That child came back to life. Is it well? I said, is it well? It is well. It is well this year in Jesus' name. A peaceful posture. Look at verse 38 of Mark chapter 4. Mark chapter 4. In Mark chapter 4, verse 38. And he was in the inner part of the ship asleep on a pillow. That's the sleep of dominion. It's the sleep of dedication. It's the sleep believing. I'm not going to die in the sea. I'm going to the cross. I'm going to pay for the salvation of the world, and the sea will not drown me. The waves and the storms will not be able to drown the master. Look at this. I want you to show something today. Isaiah chapter 43. Isaiah chapter 43. And I'm reading there from verse 2. Isaiah chapter 43, verse 2. Are you there? When thou passest through where? The waters, I'll be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, ye shall not be burnt, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Do you know what happened here? If you look at this verse, there are two different parts there. Number one, through the water, through the river. Number two, through the fire. The second part had been fulfilled. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were going through the fire. And Jesus Christ was with them there. And the fire did not burn them. And now the Lord wanted to give opportunity for these disciples that the other part of the verse would be fulfilled in their lives. And then they began to cry out. Why didn't they learn from Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego that when they were passing through the fire, they did not cry, they did not shout, they did not shed tears, they just know we're passing through. And this year, we're passing through. I said, we're passing through. And the Lord Jesus wanted them to understand, even though the fire was there, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were not burnt in the fire because they were to pass through. And now the second part, to pass through the rivers and pass through the water, that has now come, and they were to pass through. Because then let us go on, pass on to the other side. And then they began to cry. You know that kind of crying. This year, there's no crying. When you have temptation, no cry. When you have trial, no cry. When you have persecution, no cry. When the fire appears to be burning and Nebuchadnezzar is heating up his fire, this year, I'm not going to cry for Nebuchadnezzar. I'm not going to cry for the devil. You are going to just say, Nebuchadnezzar, go ahead and do your worst, and then the Almighty God will do his best. In your life, God will do his best in Jesus' name. And when you're passing through the waters and through the rivers, you'll not be drowned in Jesus' name. And so we have a peaceful posture that Jesus Christ just went to sleep. Can you practice that this year? When there is a storm, just sleep. And when there's opposition, just sleep. You know, when you sleep, you don't argue when you're sleeping. You don't fight when you're sleeping. You don't struggle when you're sleeping. I don't try to, you know, contradict anybody when you're sleeping. When the devil is bringing up this and causing commotion, just go to sleep. And when you go to sleep like that, a miracle will happen. Let me show you. In Acts of the Apostles chapter 12. Acts of the Apostles chapter 12. When Herod was, you know, going to kill Peter, the apostle, he just went to sleep. And that shows that we minimize the power of the enemy when we go to sleep. You know, when you get up and you're crying, Master, Master, we perish. You're trying to magnify the devil. You're trying to say the devil can kill you when Jesus let us pass over to the other side. When Jesus said, I'm giving you the expected future, the expanded future, the expedient future. And then you are crying for the devil. You make the devil strong. The devil will not be strong in your life in Jesus' name. Look at Acts chapter 12. I'm reading from verse 6. And when Herod would have brought him forth, the same night Peter was sleeping. The same night Peter was being watched. He had learned his lesson. When Jesus was with them, he wasn't sleeping, he was crying out, Master, Master, save us, we perish. But now he realized, I'm going to pass through this one. I said, I'm going to pass through this one. And it will not be long, it will soon pass away. And because it will so pass away, that's why you go to sleep and just, you know, tell them, I'm not even going to pray about this one, because I said, let us pass to the other side. I'm going to the other side. I think I can have some. I need some more sleep. Maybe another 1 hour of sleep. When you say, hey, the devil is great, the devil is there, just go to sleep. I need another hour of sleep, and this year there'll be peace of mind as you sleep. Hypertension will go away as you sleep. All the, you know, hot blood, hot whatever, everything will pass away in Jesus' name. And look at this, in verse 7, behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and a light shined in the prison, and he smote Peter on the side, and raised him up, saying, arise up quickly. And his chains fell off from his hands. He was delivered. You'll be delivered in Jesus' name. I'm coming back to Mark chapter 4. Mark chapter 4, the latter part of verse 38. Mark chapter 4. We're looking at the latter part of verse 38. It says in verse 38, second part of it, and they awake him and say unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? I call that preventable panic. Preventable panic. They were panicking. But why would they panic? Preventable panic. Master, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Let me talk to these disciples a little. The Lord Jesus has said, follow me, I will make you fishers of men. That is not done yet, and that has to be done. Whatever Jesus has said to you must be fulfilled. And since he said, follow me, and we're following. And he says, I'll make you fishers of men. Until that is done, nothing can cut short your life. And so, that's not only that. He had also told them, and he said, there be some of you standing here that shall not taste of death until you see the Son of Man coming in the glory and power of his kingdom. That has not been done yet. We cannot perish here. He had said, ye are the ones that have followed me in this generation, in my temptations and trials, and you are going to reign with me. I'm going to give you a kingdom. That has not happened yet, and it must happen. And because of those things Jesus has said, they should be looking for. They shouldn't be thinking we're going to perish. Look at all the things the Lord has been telling us. And he's going to say, and he's saying, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do this. And those things have not been done yet until everything has been accomplished. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. His word will be fulfilled in your life in Jesus' name. Preventable panic. They shouldn't be panicking at this time. Look at Luke chapter 12. Luke chapter 12. I'm reading there from verse 7. Luke chapter 12, verse 7. But even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore, ye are more valued than many sparrows. That's why I said that panic is preventable. Think on the word of God. Meditate on the word of God, and you'll find that those things are not necessary at all. Number 5, prevailing power. Prevailing power. Come back to Mark chapter 4. Mark chapter 4. Here we have prevailing power. In Mark chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 39. And he arose and rebuked the wind, and said unto the sea, peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. That is prevailing power. And Jesus is still the same. He's not weaker today than he was before. The Bible says Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Any storm in your life, he'll rise up in a moment of time. He'll calm everything in Jesus' name. Number 6, penetrating perception. Penetrating perception. I'm looking at verse 40. In verse 40, and he says unto them, why are you so fearful? How is it that ye have no faith? And they were looking at one another. How is it? He said, not you have no faith. That's his perception of them. And it was a kind of penetrating perception. You know why? He said, I gave you the promise. Why didn't you believe my promise? Why is it you have no faith in my promise? Let us go over to the other side. I gave you a proclamation. And I said, let us go over to the other side. How is it you have no faith in my proclamation? I told you that we're going to eventually get to Jerusalem. and the people will take me and they will kill me. I told you I'm not going to die in the sea. Why didn't you have faith in my prediction? That's what he was telling them. He said, how is it you have no faith? Remember all that the Lord has told you. All your tears will dry up immediately. Remember all the promises of God that the Lord has given you. All your sorrow, everything will dry up immediately. And remember all that the Lord has showed you before. I'm going to do this in a dream. I'm going to show this in a service. I'm going to give you this while you are praying. I'm going to do this and that. Remember all those things. And then all this panic and fear and everything will vanish away in Jesus' name. His presence is enough to calm the storm. His proclamation is good enough to calm the storm. His promise is great enough to calm every storm. His prediction, his prophecies, they are great enough to calm every storm. That's why this year there's no panic. There's no worry and there's no anxiety. And we're going to live a fulfilled life in Jesus' name. Number seven. It's profitable persuasion. Profitable persuasion. They now became persuaded of who their Savior was, who their Lord was. And you need to be persuaded, who is your Savior? Who is your Lord? Who is the one that says, I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you? A profitable persuasion. Look at verse 41. And they feared exceedingly, and said unto one to another, what manner of man is this that even the wind and the sea obey him? Look at Matthew chapter 14. Matthew chapter 14, the profitable persuasion. Now that you know Christ is, and you are persuaded beyond any shadow of doubt that he is Savior, that he is Lord, that he is God, and that with him all things are possible. He never lost a battle, and this greater one lives on the inside of you. It's in the boat with, it's in the ship with you, it's in the family with you, it's in the ministry with you, it's in the church with you, it's in every situation you find yourself. And therefore you have this profitable persuasion that you know no evil will befall you in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 14, I'm reading there from verse 32. Matthew chapter 14, verse 32. It says, And when they were come into the ship, the wind ceased. Your wind will cease. Your storm will be calm. Then they that were in the ship came and worshipped him, saying, of a truth, thou art the Son of God. Of a truth, thou art the Son of God. What have I got to fear with this Son of God with me? He is Emmanuel, God with us. He is the captain of our salvation and is with us. He is the conqueror of death and the devil, and he is with us. He is the Alpha and the Omega, and he is with us. He is the bridegroom that will never leave the bride, and he is with us. And he is the one that saves our deliverer, and he is with us. He is our friend all the time. He is with us. He is our healer. He is with us. And if he is with us, then what this profitable persuasion? What have you got to fear? You'll not fear your life anymore in Jesus' name. Every day of your life, you remember, things are going to be better today than yesterday. It's going to be higher today than yesterday. I'm going to be healthier today than yesterday. I'm going to be stronger today than yesterday. And then today is a day of more and more. It will happen in Jesus' name. Now, they came to the other side. Thank God they came to the other side. I said, thank God they came to the other side. All the people that heard his word, that were in the boat with him, let us pass over to the other side. Everyone without exception got to the other side. As I look at you this morning, everybody hearing what we're saying this morning, everybody without exception, we're getting to the other side in Jesus' name. Because they all came to the other side. I'm so confident and happy that this year I'm already there on that other side. I said I'm already there on that other side. I want you to come now to Mark chapter 5. Mark chapter 5. Mark chapter 5. We're looking at verse 1. And they came over onto the other side. Not just he and they. Jesus and them. And they came over onto the other side. Point number 3. The privilege of Christians with an expanding future. The privilege of Christians with an expanding future. I'm going to go through and just run through with you in this chapter 5. And then you will see why he said, let us go over to the other side. I'm looking at verse 1, chapter 5, verse 1. And they came over onto the other side of the sea, into the country of the Gadarenes. Number one, we're talking about great fulfillment, great faithfulness, and glorious freedom. Great fulfillment. Don't you see? It was fulfilled. This year, there's a great fulfillment in your life. And then there is God's faithfulness. In the faithfulness of God, he came over to the other side. And then there's a glorious freedom. That's what you have this year. Faithfulness, fulfillment, and freedom. It will happen in Jesus' name. Look at verse 2. In verse 2, and when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tomb a man with an unclean spirit. Look at verse 15. In verse 15, it says, and they come to Jesus and see him that was possessed with the devil, and had the legion sitting and clothed and in his right mind, and they were afraid. You know what had happened here? Number one, dominion over demons. Dominion over demons. Jesus said, what's your name? And the man said, legion. And just said, get out. Immediately, there was total deliverance. Number two, deliverance from demons. Number three, the declaration of deliverance. The Lord said, go home to your friends and tell your friends what great things the Lord has done for you. This year in our life, there's going to be dominion over demons. This year in our lives, deliverance from demons. And this year in our lives, there's going to be the declaration of our deliverance and dominion in Jesus' name. I come to number 3 now. Look at verse 22. Verse 22 of this, Mark chapter 5. And you see what happened when they got to the other side. Look at verse 22. And behold, there cometh one of the rulers of the synagogue, Jairus by name. And when he saw him, he fell at his feet and besought him, in verse 23, greatly, saying, my little daughter lies at the point of death. I pray thee, come and lay thy hands on her, that she may be healed, and she shall live. By the time Jesus got there, the child was dead. Anything to worry about? I said, anything to worry about? The answer is no. Look at verse 39. In verse 39, here is what the word of God records. And when he was coming, he says unto them, why make ye this ado and weep? The damsel is not dead, but sleepeth. Well, they had their own reaction, but look at what happened in verse 41. And he took the damsel by the hand and said unto her, Talita Kumai, which being interpreted is, damsel, I say unto thee, arise. And straightway the damsel arose and walked. On this other side, what happened? Number one, we have the prayer of desperation. That's Jairus coming to Jesus Christ, come, 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 before my child dies. And then after that, we have power over death. Power over death. Number three, the proof of his divinity. It's not just man. This is God in human flesh. And he had the proof of his divinity. You have the prayer of desperation. You have the power over death. And then you have the proof of his divinity. I'm coming into this chapter 5 again. That's what the Lord is telling us. This new level we're getting to now, this year, is an expanding future. I said it's an expanding future. That's why he does this, he does this, he does this, because he does expanding and expanding everything. Look at verse 25. In verse 25 of chapter 5, it says, and a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years and had suffered many things of many physicians and had and has spent all that she had and was nothing better, but rather grew worse when she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garments. For she said, if I may but touch his clothes, I shall be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that explain. What do we find there? Number one, the expression of faith. She said, that's expressing her faith. If I'm able to touch his garments, I shall be made whole. Number two, the exploits of faith. She touched and she became well immediately. Number three is the expectation by faith. That's your expectation this year. You are going to touch the Lord every this year. All infirmity will pass away from your life in Jesus' name. Mark chapter 5 verse 34. Mark chapter 5 verse 34. And he said unto her, daughter, thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace. It's going to happen today. And behold of thy plague. You know why that happened to her? Number one, the confession of the incurable. Because that's why she was healed. Because she came to the Lord and made a confession. She had been incurable. She had spent everything she had. But everything, there was no solution. But she made a confession. And then number two is the compassion for the incurable. The Lord will have compassion upon you this day and this week and this month and this year in Jesus' name. And then number three, the cure for the incurable. Cure for the incurable. There's no incurable sickness anymore in our midst. I said, no more incurable sickness in Jesus' name. Because there's compassion, there's confession, there is cure. I'm looking at verse 37 now. In verse 37, it says in verse 37, and he suffered no man to follow him, save Peter and James and John, the brother of James. What's happening here? Jesus wants to go and raise the dead. And then he gave a special privilege to these three, Peter, James, and John. And you are, this coming to the other side. If you will keep on following after the Lord until the other side, there's going to be, number one, a special privilege that all the other people did not have. Number two, there's going to be spiritual training. He was going to train them on how to raise the sick. You find out in Acts of the Apostles, Peter raised the dead because the Lord gave him spiritual training at this time. So we have spiritual preparation, and then spectacular promotion. That's what happened to these people because they came to the other side. That's why I'm making up my mind. I'm listening to the word of the Lord, and the Lord has told me, and the Lord is telling us as a church, pass over, let us pass over to the other side. And I'm making up my mind, I'm not going to remain in the past. I'm going to pass over with the Lord in Jesus' name. And then I am going to have, and you are going to have, a special privilege. Give me a good amen. Amen. A spiritual preparation, another amen. Amen. And a spectacular promotion in Jesus' name. Amen. Now I come to chapter 5 verse 19. Chapter 5 verse 19. Howbeit Jesus suffered him not. And but saith unto him, go home to thy friends. Go home to thy friends and tell them how great things the Lord has done for thee. This man had no home before, because he was just in the tomb. He was here and there hurting himself. And Jesus now made him well. And then he didn't send him back to the tomb. He sent him to his home. He said, go home. Home for the homeless this year. Then I want you to look at verse 26. In verse 26, and she had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. And this woman that Jesus healed, this is help for the helpless. Help for the helpless. Number one is home for the homeless. Help for the helpless. Look at verse 36. Verse 36. It says, as soon as Jesus heard those words that was spoke, the word that was spoken, he says unto the ruler of the synagogue, be not afraid, only believe. This is hope for the hopeless. You know what Jesus gave them in this chapter? Number one, he gave hope for the homeless. He gave help for the helpless, and he gave hope for the hopeless. And then you see, as you look at this chapter, and it says, let us pass over to the other side. All the things we didn't see in chapter 4, that is what we see here in chapter 5. And I'm saying that all the things you've never seen in your past years, this new year, you're going to see them in Jesus' name. Let me summarize before we pray. Are you ready? Number one, in this chapter you find blessing for a man, blessing for a woman, and blessing for a child. Look at the chapter. The man that was demoniac, the woman that was an incurable, and the child that was dead is for the whole of humanity. The man, the woman, and the child. Number two, you find power over demons and power over disease and power over death in this chapter alone. That's why he said, let us pass over to the other side. As you look at this chapter, there is nothing that is left. There is victory throughout. And this year is the year of victory throughout in Jesus' name. Number three, as you look at this chapter all over again, you see restoration for that man, recovery for that woman, and resurrection for this child. There was restoration, there was recovery, and there was resurrection. And the Lord is telling us this year is a year of restoration. It's a year of recovery. And it's a year of resurrection in our lives in Jesus' name. Look at this chapter again. You are going to find number one, faith. You are going to find number two, freedom. You are going to find number three, fellowship. Because he restored that child back to the fellowship of the family. And the Lord is saying that this year is not the year of unbelief. It's a year of faith. It's a year of freedom, and it's a year of fellowship in Jesus' name. Look at this chapter again. You are going to find number one, prayer. The natural of the synagogue came to Jesus pleading passionately. There was prayer. Number two, there's persistence. As the people came and they said, leave the master alone. Why are you troubling him? The child is dead already. He will not let go. You will not let go this year. There is prayer, there's perseverance, and there is power. And Jesus said to Lita Kumai, and that child rose up, and there was real manifestation of power. Come over to this chapter again. You know, I've been looking at the disciples, and the disciples, they always argue about this and argue about that. I don't find any argument in this chapter at all. I don't find any kind of contradiction in this chapter at all. I say, in this chapter, when he said, let us go over to the other side, number one, no conflict. Number two, no criticism. Number three, no carnality. You're going to find that the lives of the disciples in this new chapter of chapter 5, no conflict at all between them, no argument at all. They just followed. They were in agreement together. This year will be the greatest year for our church in Jesus' name. No conflict in this year. Among all our workers with their leaders, there will be no conflict. Among all our members of their pastors, there will be no conflict. Among all our people who are overseers, there will be no conflict. No conflict, no criticism, and no carnality. Only observation, obedience, and opportunity. As you look at them, you are just observing what Jesus was doing. Just open your eyes this year and see. You will see the goodness of the Lord in Jesus' name. Don't criticize anything or anybody. Just observe. Just obey, and then your opportunity will come in Jesus' name. Have you looked at this chapter again? And then you are going to find there is a positive attitude. Positive attitude. As you look at all of them, you know, the demoniac came, and the disciple, you don't say he's crying too much. Everybody just had a positive attitude. That's why he says, let's pass over to the other side. And then they had a practical activity. This chapter is a chapter of activity. He's casting out devils, he's healing the sick, somebody is touching Jesus Christ, and then Jesus is walking there, he's taking all these people, he's getting to that house, and then he's saying, rise up. It's a chart of activity, practical activity, and then progressive achievement. You're going to find it moved on from delivering the demoniac and then raising that person that was sick and then even raising the dead. A progressive achievement. Your February will be greater than your January. Your March will be greater than your February. And your April will be greater than your March. And your December will be greater than your November. This year, progress in Jesus' name. You know what I discovered? This chapter is a chapter of just coming. When he said, come over to the other side, then we're told that they, in verse 1, they came over to the other side. Then we read another verse there. I don't have time to show it to you. The demoniac person came over to the Lord Jesus Christ. And then we read of that ruler. He came to the Lord Jesus Christ. And then we read of that woman, that had issue of blood, and she came to the Lord Jesus Christ. Then we read of Christ himself. He came to that house. And then we read of that that little child, it came back to life. This is a year of coming to the Lord. And when you come to the Lord, everything you have in mind, you are going to have it in Jesus' name. A fruitful year, a productive year, a happy year. Now it's time, let's pass over to the other side. Are you ready? Pass over to the other side. Just look at the past and bury the past. And let the past be drowned in the river that we are passing through. And say, oh Lord, I thank you. Because this year is a year of the faith journey to the promised future. Open your mouth and pray to the Lord. Faith journey that we are making to the promised future. You have something good awaiting you. You have something beautiful awaiting you. You have a joyful year, a happy year, a prosperous year, a pure year, a better year, a glorious year awaiting you. And the Lord is saying, let us pass over onto the other side, onto the other side. And he kept on and kept on and kept on until they came to the other side. Remember the words for this year, the watchword for this year, the word better. The watchword for this year is the word higher. The watchword for this year is the word stronger. The watchword for this year is the word purer. No yielding to temptation this year. No sinning this year. No defilement, immorality this year. Pure and higher. Pure and whiter. Pure and holier. Healthier, no sickness. Greater, no failure, no defeat. A year of more and more. A year of more and more. A year of more and more. Get up, make your journey. Establish a powerful partnership with the Lord. He will not leave you, don't leave him. Put your hand in his hand. Let him lead you on. He cannot fail. He will not fail you. There may be predictable problems. Don't allow those problems to intimidate you. Predictable, they will come. What does that matter? You are the one who has solution to every problem, abiding with you, abiding in you. Peaceful posture. Go to sleep. Don't worry, go to sleep. Don't be anxious, go to sleep. Preventable panic. Don't panic. Don't fear. Don't confess negative. He's still in the ship. He's still in the boat. He's still living in your heart. He's still in your home. No unnecessary tears, unnecessary crying this year. Prevailing power. Christ Jesus has the power. No matter the challenge, no matter the problem in your life, Christ Jesus has the power. Penetrating perception. Manifest faith in his presence. Faith in his promise. Faith in his prediction. Faith in the prophecies of the word. Faith in the power of the word. That's able to destroy all the works of the devil. Don't you know? The hair on your head are all numbered. You have greater value than many sparrows. Say, yes, Lord, I believe. Let there be a profitable persuasion. Be persuaded more than beyond any shadow of doubt that this is the Son of God, the one who is able to calm every storm. Is the Alpha and the Omega, captain of our salvation, the conqueror. Is a Savior. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. He is our healer. He is our deliverer. He is our redeemer. He is King of kings and Lord of lords. He is a purifier. He is a sanctifier. And he is the baptizer in the Holy Ghost. Come over now to the other side and see God's faithfulness. And see the great fulfillment of his word. And experience his glorious freedom. Enjoy his deliverance and dominion. He has power over death. Don't you let anybody threaten your work, death. He has power over death. The proof of his divinity. This is the God you believe in. This is the Christ you believe in. The one that has told you for this year, let us pass over to the other side. No sickness is incurable. He has compassion for the incurable. And let the incurables make a positive confession. There will be an irresistible manifestation of his healing power. There will be cure. Express your faith to the Lord. This year, excel in faith. This year, take your special privilege. Let there be a spiritual preparation. Spectacular promotion coming your way. Help is near. Help is near. He is the hope of the hopeless. Help to the helpless. And healing to those who are hurting. In Jesus' name we pray. Now today we're going to make it a new different. You'll say, you will say, in Jesus' name I pray.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Say that again.
In Jesus'
name I pray. Let the heavens hear you.
In Jesus' name
God has answered your prayer in Jesus' name. This is your year. It's a year of joy. A year of happiness. A year of healing. A year of prosperity. A year of promotion. A year when all things are possible. It will happen in your life in Jesus' name. God will put testimony in your mouth. Everywhere you turn, left, right, forward, back, everywhere, there will be testimony in your mouth in Jesus' name. The power of the Lord will not fail in your life. All the good things the Lord has promised you to make your life better, higher, stronger, healthier, purer, holier, more and more, the Lord has fulfilled already in Jesus' name. Raise up those hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this climax of our covenant month. Thank you for good people who are here today. Oh Lord, I pray that you will do something supernatural and special, spectacular in every life in Jesus' name. All the guilt and the burden of past sins, oh Lord, I pray this very day, remove them. Amen. Cleanse your people. Amen. Wash your people. Amen. Purge your people. And let your real salvation that makes new creatures come into every life even today in Jesus' name. The failures of the past, the defeats of the past, all those things are gone in Jesus' name. I pray, Lord, manifest your power in every life. Lord, bring everyone to the other side. And the expected future, the expedient future, the expanding future that you have promised everyone, brother, sister, boy, girl, youth, adult, that you grant to everyone in Jesus' name. Break every yoke in every life. Destroy the works of the devil. Take all the weaknesses away and make your people strong in the Lord this year in Jesus' name. Any infirmity, any sickness in your life right there, I speak against that sickness right now. And that incredible sickness, I speak against it. Come out in Jesus' name. Any demonic force or power operating any life that is ruining and destroying the lives of your people, oh Lord, I take authority over them. And I break every yoke in your life in Jesus' name. All that poverty, I cancel it. All the defeat, I cancel it. All the oppression in the night, I cancel it. All the sorrow and the tears, I cancel everything. Lord, put laughter in the mouth of all your people. Let this year be a really new year for everyone in Jesus' name. Bring us to this new side. Everything we're ready about, everything will be opened up in this next chapter, which is the chapter of the next level and the chapter of the other side. I pray fulfill it in every life in Jesus' name. Every day, Lord, for this year, for your people, more and more. Amen. In their homes, more and more. Amen. In their schools, more and more. Amen. In their universities and colleges, more and more. Amen. In their working places, those working in the church, outside the church, more and more. Amen. Everywhere, Lord, more and more. But you know, all our workers in various sections, so Lord, more and more. Amen. Lord, I just pray this year will be a year of testimony for everyone. Confirm it in every life, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, turn to your neighbor and encourage them and say, this is your year of more and more. This is your year of more and more. This is your year of more and more. God confirm the word of our mouth. Amen.